Another great thing that I absolutely love is controlling what happens up here. They say, you know, you can't control what happens to you, just how you respond to it. Right? We've all heard this. It's on a pillow on your couch, probably. But it's true. And here's how it works. There are a lot of things that happen to us in the world that we have no control over. People giving us stuff and saying, hey, I need this tomorrow. You don't have anything else going on, right? A lot of things that happen. People come in late to my workshops. Perfect example. Things happen that I have no control over. But I have certain thoughts and judgments about what happened that cause emotions that make me behave and react in a certain way that get me the results that I get. Perfect example. I call a meeting. Somebody comes in late. My thoughts and judgments on lateness is that it's disrespectful, unprofessional, that person doesn't have their stuff together. So I feel angry. I give them a dirty look through the meeting, blow off their ideas, and the results I get are a damaged work relationship and a negative environment. Same person comes in late. Tina is a single mom, and she knows, I don't know if she is or not, by the way, I'm not spreading rumors, but she's a single mom, and she understands that sometimes her life is not her own. And sometimes you can't, no matter how much time you get leave to get somewhere, your life gets hijacked. And so when that person comes in late, exactly the same meeting, exactly the same day, her thoughts are, wow, they must have a lot going on, and our time is not always our own. She feels empathy, and maybe her behavior or her reaction is to walk up and say, hey, is everything okay? You're not usually late. And, you know, thinking maybe there's something wrong. Is there anything I can help with? And the result she gets is building up of that relationship and the ability to work with that person after. So exactly the same thing happened, but because of our thoughts and judgments about that thing, we had different emotions and thus a different experience. Okay? And this is a perfect example for me in facilitation, because I go into companies all the time and do talks and do workshops and stuff like that. Inevitably, somebody is late. And for the first 2 or 3 months of teaching all the time, I was pissed off almost every day because people are always late. And so I'd be like, oh, they're so disrespectful. It's all about me, right? And so after a couple weeks, a couple of feeling angry and hangry, I needed to stop and reframe the way I was thinking about this because the experience I was having was not effective. So what I had to do was back it up and say, what are the judgments and thoughts that I'm having about lateness? What is the story I'm telling myself? I'm saying they are disrespectful and unprofessional. However, is that the only explanation? What story am I telling myself, and is that the only story? And the answer was no. Maybe they were out in the hall talking to the CEO. Or maybe a little more important than me. Or maybe they were on the phone with their kid's oncologist. Way more important than me. And so as we start to reframe the stories we're telling ourselves or the thoughts and judgments on the things that we don't have control over that are happening, we start to change our emotional experience with them. So is there a thing in your life that happens again and again and again that really pisses you off, but you're not going to be able to control it? How can you reframe this? And the beauty of this is when you shift the emotional reaction, you put a stop sign between the emotions and your behavior, so that your caveman brain takes a break and your rational brain says, okay, how do I want to deal with this to get the results that I want? You just get a little extra second to be able to decide rather than just reacting. So now when people come in late, if I first get indignant, I'm like, oh, and then I'm like, oh, maybe they were with the CEO. I get it, and I can get over it. Think about this. How can you reframe what you're thinking? And I had somebody in a workshop once say, all right, you know, I'm getting what you're saying. This is very positive and like changing your thinking, and that's really cool. She goes, how about this one? Every time I delegate something to one of my employees, she rolls her eyes. And the whole room was like, ooh, like, how are you going to deal with that one? And I said, yeah, that's really rude. She's like, yeah, it's really disrespectful. I'm like, yeah, it is. I said, why do you think she does that to you? She goes, oh, my God, she does it to everybody. I'm like, oh, she does it like to everybody? So pretty much everybody. I'm like, then why are you taking it personally? It's not about you. It's still disrespectful, sure. But think about the results that person is getting in their life. So the story she was telling herself was this person is being disrespectful to me. But but it wasn't about her. This is that person's way of dealing with life. So instead of letting it ruin her day, she was like, oh, it's not about me. And she tells herself now that now, when this person rolls her eyes, it's not about me. I'm going to not let this ruin my day. This is how we start to bust down the stress of these things that we can't change that keep happening.